call the meeting of January 27, 2016, the order. Please stay seated in the roll call.
Robert Smith?
Here.
Maria Zapaznik?
Here.
Lori Sapano?
Yes.
Noah Carston?
Here.
Thomas Lima?
Here.
Shane Krillin?
Here.
Leander Alvarez?
Here.
Gilbert Carreras?
Here.
Brittany Frazoco? Connor Gerlach?
Here.
Nicori Zaridia?
Here.
Emma Holman?
Here.
Patrick Hurd?
Here.
Joshua Locke?
Here.
Logan Roush? Jose Rosario?
Here.
Kenneth Salhini Jr.?
Here.
Jason Windra?
Here.
Scott Kane?
Here.
Michelle Brophy Bearman? Mark Paolucci?
Here.
Robert Santori?
If you please rise for the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, we now move on to item two, approval of the agenda. I'm seeking a motion. Motion from Treasurer Carson, second from Representative Block. Thank you. Need an update on classes. All right, is there any discussion? Secretary Sedina.
I'd like to motion to add the SOC minutes of November 18, 2015.
Is there a second? Second by Treasurer Carson. Any discussion on the amendment? Hearing none, now move to a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the amendment passes. We now move on, continue with discussion of the agenda. Is there any more discussion? Hearing none, we now move on to approve the agenda as amended. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the agenda is approved as amended. We now move on to approval of minutes, deputy speaker election, and regular minutes, regular meeting minutes of December 2nd, 2015. I am seeking a motion for approval. Motion by Representative Hurd, second by Representative Locke. Any discussion on the minutes? Hearing none, we now move to a vote. All those in favor, please signify yes by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the amendments are approved. We now move on to the open forum. Is there anyone here for the open forum? Anyone here for open forum? Anyone here for open forum? Hearing none, I'm now consider the open forum closed. And we move on to item five, officer announcements. Item A, President Robert Smith.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you for coming tonight, everyone. I'm glad to see everyone survived winter break. Everyone survived the snow and a half we had over the past couple of weeks. It's not my favorite thing in the world. I hope everyone's doing great in their classes. It's the middle of their second week. I know I hate mine already because I'm a senior and I'm graduating, and this is what actual class feels like, and I'm not quite used to it. I'm a liberal arts major, that's okay. So a lot of big things have happened in the past couple of months since we last met, end of November, first of December. But before we talk about anything else today, we do have to do one thing. As you all should remember, at the end of the last meeting, we elected Shane Henry Krillin as Deputy Speaker for the replacement for, unfortunately, departing Deputy Speaker Frazoco. So we first have to induct Shane. So Shane, if you could get up. Move over there because there's no room. Where everyone can see. Shane, what's your good side, left or right? Anger to bees and Nate Sheena.
Right down the middle.
No, usually the less cramped. Jeremy, you might want to video. Okay. So, raise your right hand. To be loved. Okay. So I need you to repeat after me and then sign black boy. I, Shane H. Krillin.
I, Shane H. Krillin.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully execute the office of Deputy Speaker of Roran College Student Parliament.
That I will faithfully execute the office of Deputy Speaker of Rhode Island College Student Parliament.
Part of work that says no sense of anger. And will to the best of my ability.
And will to the best of my ability.
Protect and uphold the bylaws of SEU.
Protect and uphold the bylaws of SEU.
I will promote a sense of community.
I will promote a sense of community.
And foster the growth of student interests and welfare as a whole.
And foster the growth of student interests and welfare as a whole.
And honor the integrity of the mission of Student Parliament.
Honor the integrity of the mission of Student Parliament.
And all of its committees and commissions thereof.
And all of its committees and commissions thereof.
Congratulations, Deputy Speaker Shane. hope, Shane, you do a wonderful job as Deputy Speaker. It's a daunting job, it's a good job. And so with that, I'm going to move on to the rest of my announcements. So we should probably all talk about the elephant in the room. I think we've all heard the news after our last meeting, the fact that President Cariolo has chosen to step down at the end of the year. I know we in the SG office were very, it was a somber day when we heard the news. She's done a lot of good things for the college, like the construction of Alexander Hall. But even though she's now leaving, it's time to look ahead towards the future. I know the process to find her replacement, the search committee is going to be getting together in the next couple of months. I've heard between February and April, Dr. King might be able to speak to that. But the important thing is they're going to solicit student involvement on campus. So that means student organizations, student government, of course, and various other student groups across campus. I know there are several people on staff and faculty who are pushing the people conducting the search to do just that. So if any of you are approached to solicit student interest, what you'd like to see in the president, if any of you hear about open forums to meet the candidates when they are chosen, I encourage everyone to participate. I think I'm the only one on the body graduating. Is anyone else graduating? Anyone else on the, Connor, are you graduating? I feel less old. Kind of you graduating too? Well, thank God. But even though I'm graduating and I won't be here next year, I probably won't even have a chance to work with the new president, whoever he or she is. We're all part of a larger community here at RIC, so it's important to take ownership of that community and try to get the president we all want and the president we all deserve who's going to make RIC great. They have a lot of hard stuff against them. As we all know, Gage is still there. Capital improvements are far behind, and we still need to rent very correctly. I know Henry Barnum is still operating at a deficit. There's a lot of hard stuff coming in the next couple of years. This is probably one of the few times I say this. I'm really glad I'm graduating this year. And other news, some of you may have gotten Dr. King's emails. I know Kristen Salemi, the director of the student unit, has also been emailing reminders to students. This week and last week, there were open forums for the replacement vice president of administration and finance. Lisa Teal stepped down, effective the end of last semester. And the SG offices were invited very graciously by Dr. King to have lunch with the three candidates. And I like to think we all benefited from having lunch with the candidates. There was also an open forum, which I know you all have busy schedules, you're full-time students, we work off campus. There were open forums to meet the candidates for all the campus community, so faculty, staff, students. I'm pretty sure I was the only student there, most of them, because I don't have a life. But they were great candidates. I think all the candidates are qualified, and it's great to see on the college that we're moving past just having everyone as interim and finding permanent replacements for RIC. So people who are going to be in the long term and add to the college's institution memory. If any of you ever approached for a search committee or seen open forum for a new position on campus, I highly encourage you all to go as part of taking ownership of your college campus. I think tomorrow the counseling center is hiring a new counselor or something to that regard, and it's an open forum for the college community on that tomorrow. It was today? I thought it was tomorrow. Oh, well, that's fine. Well, so when you all see stuff like that in the future, please read your RIC emails. There are always important college bulletins that cover that. Please read Dr. Kane's emails always from the Office of Student Life and take ownership of your RIC community. So next week is going to be also the Spring Activities Fair, and I know SCG will have a table. We might even bring back the sandwich board that we have, I think, behind Maria's desk in my office. It's a great week. If you're part of any student clubs or orgs, it's a great recruitment opportunity. So you can come and take some of the free stuff we have. I think we still have free pens. We do have any water bottles left. So we're hoping to get rid of all the water bottles, stuff we ordered for recruitment at the end of the year, at some activities day. Some of the new e-board is left at the end of the year. They can order new stuff. And we have plenty of pens. So come around, drag your friends, sign them up. If they don't want to join Parliament, join a committee. I know I got four or five people that I know to join a committee today. Some of them are in this room. Some of them are not. Get them involved in student life. This is a great opportunity here at RIC to let your voice be known on the campus. It's a great opportunity. It looks great on a resume that you're even just a member of student parliament or even a member of a committee. It's a great real life experience. And that sort of coincides with my next announcement, which is I'll be reading three resignations from the body tonight, which is very unfortunate. It always usually happens around the first meetings of each semester because people have schedules to change. So I'm going to encourage everyone in this room to bring a friend and have them join parliament. I know all of you, you all are friends. None of you are social loners, otherwise you wouldn't be in the room tonight. So I encourage you all to find someone to bring the problem. Maybe not necessarily get them to join or take out a petition. They could. These meetings are open meetings. They're allowed to watch and see what the meeting's like if they're unsure. But it's always great to have new members. I mean, it's never too early to think about next year. I know I'm not coming back. Connor says he's not coming back. Ken isn't coming back. So that's three people less sitting around the table who are going to be here next year. And there's my last announcement is there are still open spots for the SDG conference. The dates for that are the conference itself is April 27th.
February.
Did I say April?
Yes.
I'm thinking towards graduation. Yeah. February 26th, February 27th, and February 28th. It's a Friday, Saturday, Sunday. The conference itself is on the Saturday. It starts at like 8 in the morning. So we're going to be traveling to it Friday night and returning Sunday morning. It's in Jersey City. We're staying in a very nice hotel. It's next to New York City. It was advertised as New York City. But what it is, we're part of a larger organization called the American Student Government Association. At least I didn't say Association, Student Government Association. Anyway, we're part of a larger organization called that, and it's a great opportunity to learn how student government works, how we can benefit the campus, and you pick up skills that you're going to use later in life. I would especially recommend it if any of you are thinking of running for any of the executive officer positions this year, so if you want to run for secretary, treasurer, speaker, deputy speaker. I know my job will be open. It's a great opportunity, and I would strongly recommend anyone who wants to go and learn the ways you can benefit Rhode Island College. So if anyone is interested, come to the office tomorrow, speak to me after the meeting, email me, Rick SUG1. I think we only have 4 people going. We have 4 spots available. The personal cost is only going to cost you roughly about $120. So if anyone wants to go, that's your chance. It's going to be a great opportunity. Jersey City isn't that bad. I'm only joking because it's not New York. But it's really a nice area. It's going to be a nice conference, and we're going to learn a lot. And that concludes my announcements, Mr. Speaker.
Well, thank you, Mr. President. Vice President Maria Sepatis.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. It's only been a week and a half already to get out. So, Rob, take me with you.
I do have a degree. Can you get a job?
I need help. Okay. So just a few things. As you'll find out later on, I'm sure you noticed there are people who were here last semester no longer here, and that means they left Parliament, and in some cases they've left the committee as well. So if you know anybody who is in the arts or in Poli Sci or any major really, who's interested in doing things with PR and elections, please let them come see me if they have any questions, or if they just wanna spur of the moment sign up, send them our way. And on that note, I'm also gonna be starting the PR for the Storky Awards, which is coming up, because we need to get that approved and sent out and take some wise and all that. So that's going to be exciting. So I'm excited to have my PR group all meet up. So if people you know are interested in helping out with that as well, send them my way. I continue promoting it, the fact that I know we discussed last semester the timeshare that we have. We are making it available to students to use or borrow for the week of spring break. It fits up to 6 people. The total is 749, somewhere around there. So if you are interested, please come to the office for more information. You will be asked to pay in cash though, no checks.
That was not correct.
What?
No one has it. Go on. Never mind.
Okay. That's pretty much it. It's all I just keep out for any social media things I put out. We will be promoting all this information over and over again. To the fact that you would be bored and sick and tired of it. Stop following me. Please don't. And I'm pretty much done, I think. This air quality is making me... I feel like I'm on an airplane.
All right, thank you, Mr. President. Secretary Laura Speeder.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Welcome back, everyone. To start off, I passed out your conflict of interest statements. If you've joined any new clubs or have left any old clubs, just cross them off, add them in, and initial next to them, and I'll collect them at the end of the meeting. Another thing is the next roundtable is February 24th. It'll be in the ballroom, so make sure you have your secretaries there. An email email went out last week. There will be another reminder at the beginning of February, and you'll also get letters in your inboxes 2 weeks before. The next thing is I'm also part of the Student Leadership Committee here on campus, and right now we're looking for nominations of students who you think on campus who go out up and beyond and should be nominated for the award. So if you have any friends, anyone you know that really does promote anything to help the RIT community, please see me after the meeting and I'll take the information down and we can have them nominated for that award. MC auditions, as Rob mentioned, are March 2nd, so I'm trying to get a feel to see whether or not this year we should have an MC host the stories or if the committee should take care of it. So if you have any friends who like being in front of a large group of people, who feel comfortable entertaining people, let them know that those auditions will be March 2nd in the ballroom. And they can email me, they can email Joan, they can stop by the office during my office hours, or they can contact me and set something up. And I have 4 parliament seats open on my committee. Luckily, all of my non-parliament seats are full, so if you want to be a part of planning the story awards, let me know. If you want to be involved with approving clubs here on campus, getting to know what ideas people have and what clubs they want to start, don't feel shy and go upstairs and fill out a committee form. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Mr. Peter. Treasurer Costa.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the new semester. I hope it's going well for all of you. A few quick things. Quick reports involving clubs' budgets will be going out and should be used to union mailboxes on Friday. So if you are a new board member or general member of a club, please let the appropriate people know that they can pick up their quick report in their student union mailbox. Budget packets are due this Friday. They are due by noon time this Friday. The office is closing at 1. And if your club does not turn in their budget packet by noon, then you do not have a budget for the following year. You need to start over the next year, come for an operating budget which has a cap on it. Please turn in your budget packet. Let all of your friends and other clubs know. Tell every board member you see of everything. Turn in your budget packet. I have 22 and I'm missing 32. So please turn in your budget packet. Budget hearings will be on February 20th and 21st, so that's when the member of the E-Board, normally the president or treasurer, comes and sits before the Finance Commission on a Saturday or Sunday and petitions their budget packet to us to sort of explain to us what they're asking for the following year. When you or your club or whatever it may be turns in their budget packet, they can pick a time there. So please keep that in mind in case the whole club works weekends, someone needs to take it off. I also need Parliament members to serve on the Finance Commission due to the resignations we've recently had. A few more seats have opened up, so I have room for 4 Parliament members and 3 non-Parliament members, I believe. So if anyone you know is interested in accounting or finance or just wants to be a part of the commission, we meet during free periods, so hopefully there's no other obligations. So if you know anyone interested, please send them my way or up to the office. We would love to have them serve on the commission. And then a special welcome to Shane as the new deputy speaker. And that is all.
Thank you. Now for my announcements. First, I'll start with leaves. I have 3 leaves. The first is from faculty representative Dr. Michelle Brophy Behrman. Dear Speaker Lima, I am dealing with a medical issue, and due to that, I have taking up a lot of time, she writes. But she does hope to return for the next meeting, so she's only asking for a leave for tonight. Is there a motion to approve? Motion by Representative Block, second by Treasurer Costin. Discussion? There are none. We're going to vote. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions? And the leave is approved. The second is from Representative Frisoco. Dear Speaker, I will be late to a meeting due to having anatomy till 7:50 p.m. She continues to write that she'll be late to every meeting and is asking for a standing late leave for 7:50 p.m. Is there a motion to approve? Motion by Representative Block, second by Representative Rosario. Any discussion on the standing late leave? Hearing none, we now move to a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the leave is approved. And lastly, for leaves, from alumni Representative Robert Century Jr., due to his work tonight,
He cannot attend the meeting, but he wishes everyone a productive meeting as well, a productive return to the spring 2016 semester. I am seeking a motion for approval. Representative Rosario, seconded by Secretary Cepeda. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the leave is approved. For my further announcements, the Bylaws Adjudication Commission is still seeking new members. We lost a non-senior, non-parliament member, and we also lost Representative Krellen moved over to Deputy Speaker Krellen, so he will still be serving on the commission. However, he will be taking the minutes, take a role as the Deputy Speaker, automatically serves on that commission. So I am seeking some Parliament representation on the Bylaws Adjudication Commission. Fortunately, there have been no major issues and no expected upcoming bylaws changes, so we haven't met. But it is a very important commission. It governs basically the governing documents of student government, and also adjudicates issues between clubs and their members and other issues as it comes up. So if you're interested, please see myself or President Smith. And that's it for my announcements. We now move on to Deputy Speaker Krellen.
Thank you, Speaker Lima. Hello, everyone. Thank you for your votes again. I really appreciate it. Excited to get going. I want to thank President Smith again for the induction and the mouthful. So I appreciate it. For those of you that are on my committee, you'll be hearing from me next week sometime about when we're going to get started the semester. And other than that, I look forward to giving you guys updates on how we're doing. So thank you.
Thank you. We now move on to Constitutions and Organization of Conference Reports. We have three constitutions, starting with the English Club Revisions, Secretary Cepeda.
All right, everyone. So we have two members from the English Club Executive Board here with us tonight. The revisions to the Constitution are just changes that they felt were necessary to avoid the ambiguity they had dealt with before. There were some issues that they had when it came to running meetings and running elections and how their membership was functioning. So they changed a few things to make it a bit more fluid. The two representatives are here. If you guys want, you can stand up, introduce yourselves, and just answer any possible questions that the members might have.
Well, I'm Mark Picard, President of the English Club.
I'm Mike Walton, Secretary of the English Club.
All right, now open up. First off, we're seeking a motion to approve the Constitution. As a motion by President Smith, second by Vice President Zapasnik. Any further discussion? Any discussion for the Constitution or to the representatives from the club? Hearing no discussion, we now move on to a vote. All those in favor of approving the Constitution over revision, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the Constitution is approved. Congratulations, Your Honor. Now have a new Constitution. All right, we now move on to item number two, Italian Language and Culture Club revisions. Secretary Cepeda.
So with this Constitution, I don't know if you guys remember last semester, they were on the agenda two other times, but because of the president's classes, she wasn't able to attend our parliament meetings. So the changes are seeking to make, the previous abbreviation was Italian American Culture Club, so it was IACC, but they changed the name of the club to the Italian Language and Culture Club, so we need to change the abbreviations throughout the Constitution to ILCC instead, and those are the only changes that are being made.
All right, is there a motion to approve the Constitution? Motion by Treasurer Coffman, second by President Smith. Any discussion? Hearing none, we now move to a vote. All those in favor of approving the constitutional changes, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions? And the Constitution revision is approved. Now move on to item three under section 6A, Hip Hop Dance Organization Reclassification. Secretary Cepeda.
Thank you. So I don't know if you remember this either. The Hip Hop Dance Organization was a club's constitution that was passed last semester. They had stated that they were just a recreational club, but when they went to finance, it became clear that they were seeking to be part of competitions. And when that happens, the clubs have to be reclassified to a performing fine arts club through that commission. So we're seeking to reclassify them. If you have any questions, Treasurer Carson knows what they've requested exactly when they went forward to finance, so you can refer any questions to him.
All right, I'm now taking a motion for approval. Is there a motion? Motion by Representative Solway.
Salhaney.
Apologies. Second by Representative Arias. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, we now move on to a vote. All those in favor of approving the hip hop dance organization reclassification, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions. And the Constitution is approved. We now move on to item 7, reports. A, Finance Commission minutes of December 2nd, 2015 and December 9th, 2015. Treasurer Paulson.
I ask that these minutes be approved and accepted with unanimous consent. They were already approved previously by the Finance Commission.
Are there any objections to approving the minutes with unanimous consent? Hearing none, the minutes are approved. Item 7B, Student Organization Minutes of November 18th and December 2nd, 2015. Secretary Sapita.
I'm seeking that the minutes be accepted with unanimous consent, and they've also been accepted by my committee.
Are there any objections to the minutes being accepted with unanimous consent? Hearing none, the minutes are approved. Updates and remarks. Administration update, Dr. Sapien.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. During President Smith's announcements, he had indicated that maybe I would have some more information about the process the post-secondary council will employ for seeking a new president for Rhode Island College. And actually, I really don't have any more information than any of you might have. I believe everyone was sent an email with an attachment that was a letter from the chair of the post-secondary council, Mr. William Folks. So I think students got it, faculty and staff received it as well. And that's pretty much the extent of my knowledge regarding that process, that they do expect to obviously interview, talk to a lot of different constituencies on campus about Rhode Island College's needs, and then engage a professional search firm, which is fairly typical these days, to seek a new president. And they had previously indicated that maybe they would start that process in February. So I would expect that that might be the earliest where we would see some folks from the post-secondary council come on campus and start collecting some information. But finding a new president is, searching for a new president is a involved process, and I think that we could expect that it will take several months for that to be concluded. I think, you know, there would be great hope that they would be able to make that announcement before the end of the spring semester, before students sort of got busy with their summer schedules, but just sort of knowing the way those things go, I'm not really sure that's a realistic timeline. So I will keep you updated as best as possible when I find out more information, but unfortunately at this time I just really don't have much more. I do have a lot more information though with respect to the search for the Vice President for Administration and Finance, because I'm chairing that search committee. And again, as President Smith indicated, we had three finalists come on campus. We're down to sort of the final stages of that process. The search committee's responsibility is to make some recommendations of the final candidates with their strengths and weaknesses to the president. There will be a final decision made at a level that's higher than the search committee. And there's still some pieces to go with respect to checking references and making offers and then negotiating salaries and all those kinds of requirements. But I would be fairly optimistic that process could wrap up within a couple of weeks and announcement be made to the college community within that time period. It's always possible that those who make the final decision will reject the search committee's recommendations and will sort of have to start over. Not completely over, but maybe sort of go back into the pool of people who have applied for the position or start over. But we'll just take one step at a time. The one thing I would say is our candidates who were finalists and came to campus and whose names we announced in emails and on the website, those kinds of things, many of them would prefer some confidentiality. You know, we tell them we can't guarantee that, for those folks who are involved in the process, to the extent, you know, we don't want to lose people too because their name gets released to other individuals. So I ask for your cooperation in that process as much as possible. Other sort of items, let me move to sort of construction kinds of things. So if you walk outside of the student union onto the quad tonight, you'll see lots of lights in Gage Hall. And indeed, the work in Gage has begun. It started over the semester break. The first piece of that, I think, was asbestos removal and that sort of stuff. But we'll see more construction going forward. So the plan is that the building would be available for classes in the fall of 2017. And I think we're still on schedule with that project. So more to come there. If you walked into Roberts Hall very recently, you would see that in one of the wings, there's a space that is about ready to open for the Career Development Center. The Career Development Center is being relocated out of Craig Lee. Everybody's going to have to leave Craig Lee because it's going to become under construction in a little while. But it's being relocated out of Craig Lee over to Roberts Hall, and the space is just about done. I don't think the move will take place until spring break, just because of trying to meet with students and provide service to students during the regular semester, but maybe spring break is a little bit of a downtime, so they'll make that move. But for those of you who are frequenting the Career Development Center because you're seniors and you're looking for jobs, or because you're freshmen and sophomores because you're trying to figure out what to do with a major in whatever, if one day you go to Craig Lee for your appointment and they're not there, you know where they are. They moved to Roberts Hall. And has everybody seen the addition that's going on at Fogarty? If you haven't been to the backside of campus, then I don't know if people knew about that addition, but I did, of course. But the size of it is much more extensive than I had imagined based on what the conversations that I heard. So if you haven't seen that project, take a walk by, and we expect that to be done, and I think ready for, I'm not sure if that's ready for the fall, this coming fall, or certainly next spring, 2017. And just a couple of staff announcements for those of you who live in the residence halls. You may already know by now that one of our area coordinators in the halls, Rachel Glenn Mata, gave birth over the holidays, or over the break period after the holidays. So congratulations to her. She's on maternity leave for a while, and Res Life is working to cover her responsibilities. And then for those of you who know Dr. Marissa Weiss, who has an office here at the Student Union, and if you've seen her lately, you know that she's pregnant. I don't think you can miss that now. Maybe before the holidays, there might have been some question about it, but there certainly is no question now. And so, and I know she's expecting in March, and we're excited for her as well. But obviously that will mean that she will be out for a term with maternity leave, and obviously it'll be difficult to cover her responsibilities, but we'll try to figure that out as well. I think that concludes my report. Thank you.
Yes, President.
Two questions for Dr. King. So I was a little unsure we were talking about the next processes for hiring the next VP of Administration and Finance. Who has the final decision for the hire?
Well, technically...
Who traditionally has, first of all? I know we're a little ambiguous.
Technically, I think it's legislated that the, maybe the post-secondary council bylaws, that they actually have to approve any executive appointment. So they sort of have the final say. If you're looking at sort of the newspapers recently, there was an appointment made at CCRI, which is now getting some criticism, and the post-secondary council is the ones, the individuals defending it, because ultimately they have the final say in that position. So any appointment would really be finally approved by them. Obviously, it's typically recommended by the supervisor. So in this case, for a vice president position, it would typically be a president. But I suspect there will be consultation between, you don't want to go to the post-secondary council for their final approval and bring them a name and have them sort of say, no, we don't want that. So that, typically I think there's a conversation that happens to make sure that, the approval will go smoothly.
Okay. And my second question was, I don't think any of us were here when Dr. Cariola was sworn in as president of Ronan College. I think any of us were here for John Nazarian when he was president of Ronan College. Can you give us some kind of idea what student involvement or what Ronan College does for departing incoming presidents and what kind of student involvement they solicit with them?
Yeah, so great question.
Is there a going away party?
I would absolutely expect, that as you were mentioning earlier, Dr. Cariola has served Rhode Island College very well. By the way, sort of the average tenure for a president at an institution of higher education in the United States is about 7 years. So she's 7.5, and by May it'll be pretty much 8. So, sort of a fairly above average reign at president. And typically there's some sort of, obviously appreciation for all the hard work that she's done. If you look at the campus when she arrived, if you look at the campus now, the physical, the infrastructure has really improved significantly. And I think, the institution, the post-secondary council would want to recognize that in some way. Likewise, when a new president comes on campus, too, there's a fairly big to-do inauguration of the incoming president and some type of celebratory party to, welcome them. And the last time when President Cariola came here, student community government actually sponsored the... Yeah, Mary was on the committee, she says. So he was actually sponsored. I don't know, did we call it a gala?
It was a gala.
Yeah. In that way, students would be invited to this President Cariola send off as they will be involved in the inauguration of the new president.
Thank you. That concludes my questions.
All right, thank you. My conclusion announcements. We now move on to. No faculty update tonight. No staff update, Mr. Mark Panucci.
All right, well, back then. First, I'd like to thank Lori for a great party. If you still remember, I still have my ugly sweater. Hopefully, I will not be wearing it to parliament meetings. thank you. I just want to touch on a couple of things. A few students have contacted me about whether a spring concert or a concert committee. Yes, no, maybe.
We don't really have the money for it.
Okay. And the other thing I wanted to just touch on, if we're looking for items for the spring semester, like goals to, right before the semester ended, a few professional staff people came to us and pitched some orientation, welcome week ideas, and we listened to them, and then we kind of like said thanks, and that's it. I don't know if the executive committee wants to, resurface some of those ideas and put together, an ad hoc committee, but some form of, proposal for, the summer next year, so our new leaders have something to, some foundation to work from. And that being said, too, you know, we've always talked about this at the end of the spring semester, and it's homecoming, and it creeps upon us every, you know, fall semester, and said, oh, now what are we going to do? We're going to do a group Boston, we're going to do a Women Alive, what are we going to try and do? But we never, you know, we never put something in writing to, you know, a commitment for next year's group. And sometimes we say, well, we can't commit next year's dollars, but we can kind of commit them to the concept that it's turning into a tradition. And if we want to keep that alive, it has to stay alive with this group this year to bring that forward to next year. So you got to kind of, like, start planting the seeds for next year and even the summer. And if you want to gather, I say this almost every semester, if you want to gather more members, you need to tap the freshman class. And there's enough summer activities with the new student programs and working with that department, student activities, to recruit some new members prior to September and October or November. And now we're here almost in February and seeing the light group within the parliament. So I think the executive committee needs to set some goals for the spring semester to tackle, you know, or touch upon some of those ideas. And those are, oh, and last thing, springtime leadership awards. We're always soliciting nominations for student leadership awards. They're the plaques that you see in the main stairway, somewhere between the second level and third level. And Mr. Salvini did a great job of being the MC for that event, and those that attended in previous years would say it's a good time, but nominate your student leaders. It's great to see students nominate other students and not just coming from faculty and staff. Thank you.
Thank you. There is no alumni update tonight, so we move on to item 9, appointments, resignations, and vacancies.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'll begin with resignations. I have 3 of them. First off, Megan Fisk is resigning from Parliament due to a class that conflicts with meetings, and she is also resigning from Conditions and Services Committee as well, for Public Relations, and the Traffic and Parking Committee. I also have a resignation from Parliament from Representative Linda Lynn. She is also resigning from the Elections Commission and the Calendar Committee due to personal reasons. And I have a final resignation from Representative Tromley. He was resigning from Parliament, the Finance Commission, and the Library Advisory Committee due to opportunities in his field of study becoming available that caused a conflict in his schedule. I ask that the body accept these all 3 resignations with deep
regret.
And unanimous consent.
Are there any objections to accepting all 3 resignations with deep regret through unanimous consent? Hearing none, the resignations are approved with deep regret.
Okay. With that, I'd like to move on to appointments. I'm first appointing Michael Giammarco to the non-student parliament seat on the Bylaws Adjudication Committee. I'm appointing Representative Frisoco to the student parliament seat on the Conditions and Services Committee. I am appointing Jason Johnson to a non-student parliament seat on the Elections Committee. I'm also appointing Joshua Percy to a non-student parliament seat on the Elections Commission. I am appointing Stephanie Kane to the non-student parliament seat on the Finance Commission. I'm also appointing Andrew Spaziano to a non-parliament seat on the Finance Commission as well. I'm appointing Audrey Eckel to the Student Organizations Committee as a non-student parliament member. And I am appointing Representative Frisoco to the Committee on Academic Advising, that's the College's Committee on Academic Advising. And that concludes my appointments. I ask that these be approved with unanimous consent.
Are there any objections? There are none. The improvements are made with unanimous consent.
Okay. I'm now going to read off the vacancies in all the committees that we have. Obviously, we should have 3 members of Parliament resigning from both Parliament and the various committees they were on, so there are a lot of openings. I would like to remind the body, you are all required to join the Eastern Parliament Committee and a college committee, and many of you have not one nor the other, and I'll be hunting you down this week. There are 4 student Parliament seats on the Academic Affairs Committee, and there are 3 non-student Parliament seats available on that. The Bylaws and Adjudication Committee has 2 student parliament seats open, and there is 1 non-student parliament seat available on bylaws as well.
There are only three available positions on conditions and services. One of that is a student parliament seat, the other two are non-student parliament seats. We currently have, all the student parliament seats, I'll forego the number to not embarrass Mary. We have all the student parliament seats open available on the Elections Commission. I recommend everyone join the Elections Commission. It is the second most important commission after finance. What it does is it goes over the elections and oversees elections for all the student orgs. That includes ourselves, programming, WXIN, Anchor TV, and the Anchor, as well as any clubs who want an elections official to oversee their election. And there's one non-student parliament seat available then as well. We have four student parliament seats available on the Finance Commission. There are no non-student parliament seats available on Finance. We have four spots available for student parliament members on the Personnel Evaluation Committee. Two of those have special, there's two available for just any student parliament member, and there's two more which have slightly special requirements. If you're interested in the Personnel Evaluation Committee, please come talk to me. It's a very important and serious committee. It's the committee that governs Joan and Mary, our employees of the corporation. We have many student parliament seats open on the Public Relations Committee, only one non-student parliament seat available. We have everything open on the SEC, but as I've said many times in the past semester, it's the committee that governs the spring concert. There are many problems going on with that, and this body will be dealing with that in the upcoming semester, hopefully once and for all, then we can figure it out. There are four student parliament seats available on the Student Organizations Committee. There are no non-student parliament spots. And that concludes the SDG committees. I'm now going to move on to the college committees, which are just as important as the SDG committees, because this is how you find out what's going on at RIC in these specific areas. We have one more spot in the Committee on Academic Advising. I don't think I've ever heard one nice thing said about academic advising here at RIC in my many years here. I know I have many things to say about it. I believe she's not here, but I believe Dr. Brophy Behrman chairs that committee, and she's very nice. I was on that committee once upon a time. Many of you might remember, I think I spoke on a last meeting about a survey of academic advising of professors and advisors and advisees, and she was in that committee, compiled that and put that together now 2 years ago, this upcoming spring. There's a spot open on the Committee of Academic Policies and Procedures. You can find them in the student handbook. It's the academic procedures that govern classes, majors, and stuff like that. There are two student undergraduate seats on the Academic Standing Committee. For those of you who don't know what that one is, if a student gets into trouble or is accused of something like plagiarism or cheating, they go before a body that has got faculty and staff on it and two student representatives. So that is also an important committee. I would ask everyone, if you wanted to be on it, to be very sober and serious about it. We have two student seats available on the Calum Committee. What that is, it sets the calendar for running college. So if you go on the website and choose where calendar, the calendar bends, the academic calendar for the year. That's about it. Let's see. We have two spots available on the Committee on College Lectures. That chooses any lectures that are done around college. The schedule, who chooses the speakers. Any of you interested in that, I ask you to join. There's one spot available on the commission, on the Committee on College Mission and Goals, which chooses the College Mission and Goals. It's pretty self-explanatory. There is one spot available on the General Education Committee. It's the committee that decides what the general ed requirements are. If you've been here longer than 3 or 4 years, they've changed quite a bit, all the general ed requirements. I've now lost count of the times they changed, the time I've been here. I think we're Tom, what, three or four?
A few.
They've changed it quite a few times here at RIC, so if you hated the way your gen ed program was, I ask you to join. There is one spot available on the Library Advisory Committee, which deals with the library. We have two non-student parliament seats on the PFAT Commission. We have two student parliament seats on the Student Design Course and Concentration Subcommittee. That's a subcommittee of the Curriculum Committee. Anyone's curious. And we have a grad student spot and a non-resident student spot at the Committee on Student Life. we have one more spot available on the Traffic and Parking Committee. The other complaint I always hear about Rick is parking. I've never heard a good thing about parking. So if you care about the way it is and want it improved, I ask you to join that committee. And then we have two student spots available on the Vision 2020 Committee, which is the college's 5-year plan, and I promise you it's not a pun. I was on it last year. I think it was referred to as the Strategic Planning Committee. You get a lot of information on where the college is and where it's going in the next 5 years. So if perhaps you're a freshman or a sophomore, you'll get to see what the college wants to do in the time that you're here. And that is all the vacancies I have for all the committees. In the future, I'm probably not going to read every single one because you all get tired of my voice. But I will be hunting all of you down personally to join a committee if you haven't already. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Mr. President. We now move on to issues of parliament members. If you have an issue, please raise your card and keep it high. Deputy Speaker Grellin will keep the list. President Smith.
Come on, I've done 90% of the job. Really? When is that again? I love it. Why is it?
All right, President Smith.
All right, well, I was hoping there would be more discussion, but I'll do this. Like I said during my announcements, during the spring activity fairs next week, I encourage everyone to come out. WRXN would be DJing, so it'll be me and Tom choosing the music, and we're very hyped and excited about it. And that's all I have.
All right, thank you. And if there are no other issues of parliament members, there is only one motion in order, and that is a motion to adjourn. Is there a motion to adjourn? Motion by Representative Hurd, second by Representative Alvarez. There's no discussion, we now move on to a vote. All those in favor of adjourning, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, no. Abstentions, and we are adjourned. Please stay seated and silent for roll call.
Robert Smith?
Here.
Maria Zapaznik?
Here.
Lori Cepeda?
Here.
Noah Karsten?
Here.
Thomas Simba?
Here.
Shane Krellin?
Here.
Leandro Alvarez?
Here.
Gilbert Ferreras?
Here.
Brittany Frizzoco?
Here.
Connor Gorilla?
Here.
Nicori Saridia?
Here.
Emma Holman?
Here.
Patrick Hurd?
Here.
Joshua Locke?
Here.
Logan Roush? Jose Rosario?
Here.
Kenneth Salhaney?
Here.
Jason Windrow?
Here.
Scott Keane?
Here.
Michelle Brophy Behrman? Mark Paolucci?
Here.
Robert Santuri?
Thank you for that. Don't forget to recycle.